Let's turn to business news now with Giles Beckford. The future, Giles, of local insurance company Tower is up in the air again after the Commerce Commission knocked back a takeover proposal. This has been much discussed, hasn't it, from Australia's Suncorp?
It well and truly has, John. Good evening to you. Yes, it was always going to be a hard one to get across the line, given that the Commerce Commission's taken quite a staunch pro-competitive stance in its decisions this year. Remember, we've seen Sky OTV, yeah. Vodafone shot down. We've seen NZME, Fairfax Media shot down. A couple of fire protection and alarm companies wanting to merge. You wouldn't think much there, but they got shot down too. So this is the fourth big one of the year. It's coincidence, says Mark Berry from the Commerce Commission. But it does leave Tower back at the drawing board wondering, now that Suncorp has got knocked back, what happens to it? It may find that the Canadians, Fairfax Financial Holdings, who were the original suitor, making a $1.17 bid last year, they may come back into the picture, although they didn't want to go toe-to-toe with Suncorp, so perhaps they've lost any enthusiasm there. It may be that somebody else will emerge. One name that pops up is AIG, one of the big offshore players. Also that Tower may, in fact, have to go it alone. It may have to go and raise some extra capital, restructure its business. Remember, the one thing that's been on its back in the past few years has been those lingering, complex, complicated, can't solve Christchurch earthquake claims going back 5 and 6 years. And that's been the real monkey on its back. We'll wait and see on that one. The full decision from the Commerce Commission has to come out. But it'd be fair to say it's up in the air for Tower. It needs fresh money, and certainly investors are showing that uncertainty. They hammered the share price today, down 28%. That's wow. About 35 cents to a six-month low of around 90.5 cents.
Gosh, it's a big sell-off. I see casino company Sky City also got some news about its Australian assets, some values there, Giles.
Indeed, there have been questions about the Australian operations of Sky City for quite some time, about just what sort of value they were for the company, the proportion they were giving to the revenue, and whether, in fact, the investment in them was justified. Mixed news, I think, today. They finally signed the deal to upgrade their Adelaide casino, where, in fact, they've got a monopoly. They've got the biggest establishment in town with the South Australian government. They're going to have to spend a bit more, another $30 million Australian dollars, to just tweak the design for the upgraded casino. They're building a hotel. They're going to put in another floor with more bedrooms there. And in return, it's the same sort of deal that we've seen with the Auckland Convention Centre. The Australian state government, South Australian state government, is giving them an extended licence to operate. They're giving them permission for more pokie machines and gambling tables. And that, of course, is what helps pay for the investment. So we'll wait and see on that one. 3-year time frame is on that project. The one that's really causing them the worry is the Darwin establishment. Now, that's just small fry, really, but they've written down the value of that asset by 95 million Australian dollars. That's about a third of its book value. One has to say, is it worth it to stay in there? There may not be too much value in trying to sell it at the moment. It's got to find some way of getting the money out of that asset. The problem for that, for the Darwin establishment, is that the North Territory government opened up the business for pokie machines. Nobody saw it coming, and of course, bam, it just hit the Darwin Sky City for a six. So they're suffering there. We'll wait and see if there's any more news comes out of the annual result in a few weeks' time.
95 million bucks off, that's a big write down, isn't it? What happened on the markets, Charles?
Well, sorry. Just before we get to the markets, I might just note, you've just spoken about A&G Price, and I think if ever there is a company that deserves to be acknowledged as one of the backbones of this country's economy, 150 years, founded in the 1870s the Coromandel Gold Rush, it built the bulk of the locomotives for this country for a good 30, 40 years, as well as all the other heavy engineering that it did. So it's sad news that they've gone into liquidation. To be hoped that something can be salvaged from it. It's part of a broader group called the Tyrry Group, which makes Massport mowers and the like. But we'll wait and see. Fingers crossed that there's good news for the workers there. As for the markets, I can tell you the top 40 index, top 50 index, shows you how old I am, top 50 index down a couple of points at 7711. The New Zealand dollar around 74.1 US cents and 93.8 Australian.
Giles Beckford, our business editor with the Business Old Business Day. Thanks so much, Giles. Yeah, A&G Price, 100 workers losing their jobs in Thames this afternoon.